Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill, and today we are going to have one replay. But oh boy, what this replay is going to show you, it's going to be pretty much everything. Luck, knowledge, camper sniper schnitzel, reading what enemies are going to do and so on. So it's going to be quite interesting stuff. Anyways, we are playing with a Tier 9 Udes. Quite nice tank, not that nice as tier 10 because of the gun handling. Gun handling is way derper on this tank, and this vehicle have a problem of the penetration. What do I mean by saying that? The standard penetration is 234, the gold is 263. Some vehicles in the tier 8 have better penetration than this. I'm talking about the sniper schnitzels. So yeah, this is the thing to keep in mind. Anyways, what we are going to do, fellas, we are going through the 8th line in the Abbey map, and we are trying to shit on the enemies with a big smile on our face. And oh boy, we have met Bobject. You know what you can do for a Bobject in this kind of situation? I could track him, probably frontally, but I didn't do that, so it is my fault, right? Well, what can you do? Nothing. You can always take one for the team from almighty Bobject, and that's what I did. Unfortunate, but what I can say. 1/3 of the hit points thrown away in this game. Luckily, we managed to snap the Bobject. Well, not snap. We managed to penetrate him in the cupola, and right there, for obvious reasons, I am shooting only golden APCRs, because, fellas, we are fighting against the tanks which have shit ton of armor, and if we are not going to do that, it would be very, very bad and very sad. Right here, this is kind of my mistake for not loading the standard ammunition right here, because if I would load standard ammunition, more likely I would still penetrate those guys. But anyway, we are not complaining too much. It is a start of the game. 1,500 damage dealt, 0 assisting, which is very unfortunate, but not much what we can do right there. And here, fellas, we are trying to aim for a Bobject. I was trying to aim for a Bobject track, but we managed to hit the Bobject engine deck, I assume, and the Centurion is going on us, but we are not panicking right here. We are slowly but surely pur dropping down like this Centurion on the full YOLO mode, and he is going down. And now I am politely asking for the Centurion, who is your daddy? So we lost 2/3 of the hit points right there. Not much what we can do about that, right, fellas? And we still have a lot of things to do. This battle is looking quite close. Well, apart one very, very important thing. If you would pay attention over there, looks like our team is playing in the middle, which is quite unusual thing, at least in the higher tiers. But what can you do? Anyways, our team decided to make this kind of play and let it be. We cannot change too much things, and I'm still spamming gold. I did not notice it, probably that in the battlefield, that was no bueno, fellas. Anyways, this Progetto is trying to go up like this, and we are punishing him for 300 something. This tank, by the way, have 390 alpha damage. Keep that in mind if you are going to meet this vehicle in the battlefield, right? Our 277 right here is trying to fight against the Bobject, and the Bobject got him. Well, what can you do? Nothing. And now we have situation when we are trying to save this flank, right, against the almighty Bobject and against the Progetto. And I am going to sit here for a second. I am preparing for this. Look, this is 200 IQ right there. A humble streamer slash YouTuber slash Lithuanian capitalist. Look at this. I'm seeing Bobject right here, and I'm saying Bobject will blind shot. That was a good one. I read him very, very well there. And fellas, still pay attention what our team is doing, okay? This is very important part. Enemies won this area over there. Good for them. What our team is doing? Our team is trying... our team is playing in the middle right here, which is a very, very weird. It's crazy. And yeah. Well, We cannot do anything from this position if Bobject is not doing mistakes, and as you can see, Bobject is going to the other side. So what do we need to do? We are going to make pressure on the almighty Bobject right here, because we need to do something. And fellas, I am one-shottable for a Bobject. If this Bobject is going to look at my side, and as you saw before, he was spamming the gold, more likely it's a game over, right? And you know what, this is the moment when I knew, okay? When I simply knew, I messed up. 3, 2, 1, Bobject is in front of us. Bobject can snapshot. Bobject can even ram this. Bobject can even ram us like nothing, okay? Look. He used auto-aim, he hit my track, I assume, or something, and he did not manage to penetrate us, and we got Bobject into the lower plate, or however you are calling this. I'm telling you, fellas, a bit of skill, a bit of luck, a bit of all things included, right? Anyways, and right here I am thinking about making some kind of pressure for 705A and Progetto. But fellas, I cannot go on this 705. Because if he is going to turn on me, it's going to be very bad, and this Progetto can finish me up, and that would be bad. So what the smart cookie skill is doing, smart cookie skill is trying to F off from here, because otherwise it would be very, very bad, right? So I am trying to escape from this situation, which is completely understandable, right? Look, what we managed to find here, we managed to find the lonely wolf in the open field, which is called ML2. At last skill note, he said he was shooting way too many APCRs, hashtag gold noob skill, how dare you, dirty baboon. I did not notice that I was spamming gold, probably that was the main problem right there, but let it be. We still have some left, we have 6 left, maybe it's going to be enough to carry this game. And fellas, this is the gaming experience which every single of us need, and which we all waiting for, okay? What am I trying to say right there is, I believe I'm not only one who noticed the games is going 15-3, 15-4, 3-15, and so on, maximum 5-15, right? There is many games which is looking in that way, and this is not a joke, it's actual reality, okay? It is just simply crazy how many games we have like this, and this is very, very sad. What am I doing here? Why am I not in the fight? I'm waiting until this Progetto will try to do something, and I thought he is going to be smarter. I thought he is going to try to make a pressure on me or something. But looks like that was not the case, and probably he is sniping from somewhere over there, or maybe even in this corner here. And right there, fellas, we are trying to find the shot on the 705. I was expecting this guy is going to move a bit in front, but looks like that was not the case. And our Ruski Light is showing his big balls, and he's going in front without any questions asked. What did I notice at right there? I noticed that Progetto is playing in this area. So Progetto was, let's say like that. He had a safe defense parameter, which is completely understandable. But unfortunately, this Progetto was the reason why our Ruski Light died, right? But it's fine, fellas. My main mission right here is to deal with almighty Progetto. He have 17 hit points left, and a Wolverine is going down. Easy. Okay, what we are going to do now? Now we are trying to F off from here, because let's get real, on the open field, I'm not going to win against the 705A. Well, sorry, against the 705. It's the same shit, right? Just different tier. And what do we have? We have a standard B, and we have Udes tier 9, which is and the enemies have Mouse with insane armor, Defender with good armor, and 705 with a good armor. We have 6 APCRs left. It's not looking very good, right? Believe me, it's not. Anyways, 705 is trying to make pressure for us, and look, I am aiming well. I am aiming for his lower plate, unfortunately. I'm not hitting him. What can I do about that? Nothing. I can cry in the corner. That's it. And my main mission right here is pretty much to wait until the 705 will try to make pressure on us, then we can hit him, right? Aiming well into the lower plate, but RNG is saying no, no. You wasted all your RNG against the Bobject, and right there, 705A is going to beat the shit out of you. But my position is very, very good right there, believe me. I am not crying about that, I am not complaining about that. And fellas, thumbs up for our standard B, he is going to show something very, very nice. He's going to show you nice moves, so yeah. And things which we need to understand in this position. 705 more likely will go like this. Defender can find a shot on me if I will peek back like this, or if I will peek like this. Mouse, if this mouse is waiting for me over there, or even going like this, doesn't matter, by pointing his gun, he can find the shots also in quite some areas. So now we know what is happening right there. In other words, I'm sitting in some kind of shithole, okay? And it's not very funny, it's not very good. Now I thought this guy did not cross it yet, but apparently he already crossed it and he's going in front like this. Now the 705 is surprising me, fellas. This guy is surprising me. I'm trying to get hold down position right here, and this guy is just smacking me with high explosives. I did not saw that one coming. I lost quite some hit points right here. I'm trying to aim for upper plate. I should shot a lower upper plate, but it doesn't matter, fellas. I'm feeling very, very well with it. And no, I did not manage to get the tracking shot over there, but hey, he bounced, okay? Life is beautiful, we still have a chance. This guy just bounced us like this. We are dropping down and trying to survive another day, and you know what? Hello, hello, sunshine. Pay attention how we track at him. Fellas, he have gun depression, he have gun elevation. You think it's over yet? No, it's not. Or maybe it is, you never know. He noticed that he can shoot me and he bounced. He bounced the side of this vehicle. Buddy, you better shoot a high explosive. It was working better for you. Speaking of RNG, and speaking of this vehicle, fellas, we are on 5,600. There is 3.5 minutes left of this game, and skill is dancing. Look at my shoulders. I'm dancing already, okay? Anyway, standard B managed to spot the Mr. Mouse. I noticed that Mouse is over there. Now we need to figure out what to do. Mr. Defender, he can do whatever he wants. He can go like this. He can go like this. It's simply, you never know, okay? But what we know Mouse is in front of us, and we don't have any gold ammunition left whatsoever. But you know what we have? We have ability to track the almighty Mouse, and I am going to use this ability. By the way, nice pixeling we're gaming. If I'm not mistaken, I can shoot a bit through this rock, which is quite funny. But let it be, I'm accepting that. Anyways, as you can see, currently I'm just working on this mouse. I am trying to have this guy track it, and looks like he was looking at me, right? And we even loading high explosives, and pay attention at the contours right there. Mouse is bar. Looks like he's turning his turret. So next shot is going to be the standard ammunition for obvious reasons, right? We have a standard ammunition right there. Now I want to hit the mouse back, and I wish I would have more golden APCRs, because 230 2 penetration against the super heavies is not really enough. But hey, what can you do about that? Not much, right? I'm just simply accepting that, and looks like our standard B is doing quite a good job. And also in the same time, I want to be annoying for Almighty Mouse. I want to make him look at me at least, right? And I'm paying attention at this. I think Defender will get spotted, and guess who is spotted? And I did not notice at that in time. Defender is trying to find the shot on me. He's trying to find the shot on me. He find the shot on me, and RNG is saying RNG is saving us once again. That was so damn beautiful. It's crazy how beautiful that was. Anyways, Defender is moving sideways, so he took one for the team. We are already on the 6000 damage, and amazing intense game with a bit of RNG, with a bit of luck, with a bit of laughs and everything. It was the game which majority of us probably wants, right? And right there, fellas, I don't have any other option just to wait for the Defender. Defender is going in front, hip hip hooray. We managed to make him down to the one shot, so now if Defender will go on us, we are going to kill him easily. Defender is brave, but not brave enough. But fellas, this is the moment where this tank is shining, okay? This is the moment where this tank can do the things like this. Look, pay attention. Pir, 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 into cupola. Like nothing. We did not even expose it, our tank. And right there, fellas, now think about my chances. No gold ammunition. 232 penetration. Mouse is looking frontally at us. We have 13 seconds. I can be a Superman, I can be a Batman, or I can be a powerful girl. I am not going to win this battle. I cannot penetrate him frontally. I simply don't have chance, okay? Probably I wasted too many APCRs, and this is unfortunate ending, but we are ending this battle with draws. With a draw. Never or less, fellas. It was amazing game. It was one of those battles where I will remember for some time, and it was just amazing, fellas. Not victory, unfortunately, but we tried to fight for our ass. Our Ruski Light did the same. Our Standard B did the same. It was just a beautiful game after all, right, fellas? I hope you enjoyed your daily dose of skill, fellas. It was a big pleasure for me to make this video. And thank you so much for watching. Today, only one video, but oh boy, it was... I meant to say only one battle, but that battle was solid banana out of 10, right? Thank you so much for watching. See you next time. Skill is out. Peace!